Hey guys, Ashley here from Glow Body Personal Training, and today we're talking about intuitive eating because it's literally what helps me stay at my exact same weight, give or take 2 pounds, for the last 10 years. The only time that I gained weight when I wasn't pregnant or nursing, of course, is when I was deployed to Afghanistan and I was pretty much following the habits of all of the men around me and the way they ate. And so it threw my intuitive eating off track. I went up about 5 pounds and kind of stayed there. And I didn't look bad. I was just a little bit thicker than I wanted to be. It wasn't my ideal weight. So this is stuff that has taken me a while to learn. And I know it can help you. It's 4 tips that you need to follow if you want to do intuitive eating and be successful at it and feel healthy and not guilty and know that you're nourishing your body and staying in tune with how you feel, and that stays the same as you age and your hormones change because your hunger signals will change over the years too. Tip number one is listening to your body's hunger signals, specifically in the morning right when you wake up. So if you wake up and you're just not hungry and that's kind of your norm, you're just, you know, you push off breakfast until maybe 9 or 10 a.m. because you're not hungry, and maybe you have something, a coffee or a pastry because you're bored at Starbucks and that's what you call breakfast, your body is in a calorie surplus. That means you have too many calories, you're carrying extra weight that your body doesn't need, and you may have just went into that calorie surplus yesterday or the day before. Maybe you went to a party or you're eating foods that were really dense in calories and you just eat more than you needed. It happens to all of us. But when you wake up and you're not hungry, you have eaten too much, and that means your body needs to tone it back down to get to a nice caloric take where your body wants to get caloric intake where your body wants to go to its ideal weight. So if I wake up, I'm not hungry, I'm still going to eat breakfast because I want to start up my metabolism, but I'm going to have something light. So what I'll do on those days, I'll have 2 fried eggs and an apple, or a cup of blueberries, or a half a cup of strawberries. So just eggs and fruit. And that's what I'll have on a day when I'm pretty sure I'm in a calorie surplus and I don't need a big, heavy breakfast. Now, on days when you wake up and you are ravenous, you know what I'm talking about. You are hangry, you know you gotta cook breakfast for the kids, but you just wanna eat something for yourself right now. You know that you're probably in a little bit of a calorie deficit. This means that you should have a hearty breakfast. You should have something that makes you feel satisfied and not feel guilty about that because you know that's what your body needs. That really sets you up for the rest of the day. So remember how you felt in the morning. If you were in a calorie surplus because you weren't hungry for breakfast and you had no appetite at all, remember that as you go throughout your day. Remember, hey, I'm kind of in a calorie surplus right now. I don't need to be eating extra foods that I'm really not hungry for, or that don't taste good, that aren't worth their calories because you're in that calorie surplus. Number two is cravings. I get cravings too, guys. I love chocolate, ice cream, brownies, cookies, sweets, you name it, especially home-baked goods. That's my weakness. So when I have cravings for sweets, I generally let myself have a dessert a day. So whether we go out for ice cream or I have a small brownie or two, I'll let myself have dessert and not feel guilty about it. But I'm not going to sit there and have ice cream and wine and popcorn. I'm gonna pick one. So that's giving into your cravings, because if you don't give into your cravings, I think it's setting yourself up for failure, and it's something that's not maintainable long term. Now, you can set yourself up by having healthier desserts in the house that you can go to for when you have that craving versus something that's highly processed like ice cream. So it'd be much better if you had some black bean brownies around, or some garbanzo bean chocolate chip cookie from Lean Fat Strong Cable Plan. Those are healthier desserts that you can feel a little bit better about eating in moderation. But what I always remind myself when I have a craving is that my body probably needs some fat or sugar in a healthier form. So what I'll go for first, before having cookies, for example, I'll go have an apple, or I'll go have an orange, maybe with a small grab of nuts, because I'm getting my natural, you know, God-made sugars from that fruit, and then healthy fats from the nuts, or maybe half an avocado, and that'll be my snack, just a half avocado. I've got healthy fats in there, and that makes me feel satisfied, and I've realized that over time, a lot of times I'm craving sweets, but sweets is not what my body needs. It's not what's going to make my body perform or feel good or feel energetic. It's the healthy dietary fat that I may be in a little deficit of that day, and maybe I need a little bit more healthy dietary fat. So go for those other options first. Go for your fruit and a healthy fat before you give in to your cravings, and try not to give in to any type of processed sugar more than once a day. So number eight, this one is super simple, but so important. I have to just be straightforward with you. Don't be eating when you're typing on the computer with an email or on your phone or distracted to the point where you're not even tasting your food, or you look down and you're like, where did my lunch go? Did my husband steal it? What happened? And you realize, no, I ate it and I just wasn't paying attention. I think we're all guilty of that. And when we don't eat consciously, then you're not going to pick up on the signals, ding, 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 when your body feels satisfied, and you're going to keep eating until you feel full. So eat consciously and be very aware with all the smells, the textures, the flavors, so you thoroughly enjoy your food and feel satisfied. Stop there. Push your plate away. That physical reminder of pushing it away is going to help you not want to keep snacking. And then have your kids put their plates up on the counter too, because you don't need to be going for your kids' plates. You don't need to eat to the point where you're full. Last one, number four. This one is so, so important because it's really unique to each individual woman, is remembering the meals that make you feel full longer. So for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, when you eat a meal that you are surprised, it's been 3 or 4 hours and I haven't gone for a snack yet, like I still feel satisfied, those are the meals that need to be a regular part of your life that you put into your weekly meal planning routine. You're going to remember it. Oh, that chicken tortilla soup when I had a slice of wheat bread on the side, that kept me full for 3 hours and I didn't even want a snack at night. Or when I have peanut butter on my apple or on my banana, I'm not hungry till lunchtime. Those kind of things, you'll remember it, and subconsciously you're like, no, this snack or this meal keeps me fuller longer. I don't need to be snacking in the middle because it keeps me fuller. So it puts in your memory, this meal keeps me satiated. I don't need to snack or be munching on something in between because my body already feels satisfied. So that is it. That is my top four tips to eat intuitively. The main thing is that you are listening to your hunger cues and get out of the habit of snacking when you're not really hungry. When you're really hungry, your body will tell you. You don't snack or eat meals for any other reason unless you're truly hungry or you're starting up your metabolism at the beginning of the day with something nourishing. I hope this really helped you guys. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. I always love hearing what you ladies have for ideas for future workout and health videos. So let me know below. I love you ladies so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.